Now, let me show you how to use harmonics to tune your guitar. And once again, we're going to use the pitch of one string to tune its neighbor. The advantage to using harmonics is that you can get the string ringing without having to hold anything down. And of course, if it's your left hand, you can come up here and tune. So this guitar is in tune. And let me first show you how each string relates to the next. The fifth fret of the sixth string, you play the harmonic of that fifth fret, and I mean exactly above the wire. So when you play the fifth fret, your finger's behind the wire, but when you're playing the harmonic, it has to be exactly above that wire, because that's a very precise point along the string. What it's actually doing is dividing that string into quarters. There's a quarter, there's a quarter, and so what you're hearing there is actually the octave of that string, of that note. So that is an octave of that. So that should equal that, and what this is the seventh fret. So you tune the thicker string, fifth fret, to the seventh fret of its thinner neighbor. Now what this is, that's actually a third. So you're dividing the string exactly into thirds at the seventh fret and into quarters at the fifth fret. So that note should sound like that note, which it does because the guitar is in tune. Now the next two strings, exactly the same thing. You hit the fifth fret of the thicker one and the seventh fret of the thinner one. And you can hear that equals that. The next two strings, the same thing applies. The fifth fret of the thicker one equals the seventh fret of the thinner one. Now here, this is where the kink in the tuning occurs. This is where, you remember, we played fifth fret, fifth fret, fifth fret, fourth fret. So here we have a problem. We can't use that because it's not the right note. We want it actually to equal this note. But we do have this note already on this string. The seventh fret of the sixth string should equal the 12th fret of the B string. So the seventh fret there equals 12th fret there. That's a little irritating to have to do that, but that's the way it works. And then the next two strings, the E and B strings, they go back to the fifth fret of the thicker one equals the seventh fret of the thinner one. So now, harmonics are the really best used to fine-tune a guitar. Really, if you're starting from scratch and you've just restrung a guitar, it's far better to use the other system, which is the fifth fret, fifth fret, fifth fret, fourth fret, fifth fret. But once you've got it close to being in tune, they come in very handy because you can let those notes ring and you can actually hear the beating. So what I'm going to do now is I'll tune this D string down a little bit. So hear the guitar is not in tune. So now let's listen to those. That's the fifth fret of the A string, and that's the seventh fret of the D string. They should sound the same, and you can hear that they don't. But if you do listen, you can hear some beating, some pulsating in those notes, and have a very close listen as I tune up. You can actually see them in the graphic of the sound wave here. Can you hear that wobbly sound? What you want to do is keep tuning up until the wobble disappears completely, until both strings, the frequencies just gel in together. Now I can still hear a beating, it's slowing down. time too. So you can see the advantage of using harmonics is that you can get both of those strings ringing without having to hold on to anything, and makes it much easier to bring this hand down here and tune up. So it's a good way to fine tune. Also, if you're using an electronic tuner, sometimes you find that using the harmonic is a better way of sending the signal to the tuner, that it responds better to the harmonic. So, 5th fret equals 7th fret, 5th fret equals 7th fret, 5th fret equals 7th fret, 12th fret equals 7th fret of this one, and 5th fret equals 7th fret. So there you go.